Okay, in this video, like I said, we're going to do the hinge command, this area here. I went ahead and took the hinge part out, but it will, when you do the command, it will give you that. Your jeweler will probably just put a piece of wire in there and solder it up, so it's not something that you really need to have in there. So I would go ahead and delete it once you get it out. And then also, if you are a jeweler, if you've never tried it, try putting white out on those areas where you don't want your solder to flow. If they're kind of thin and get a little hot, sometimes the solder will go in there and put white out on it. So like hide this real quick. So put white out on this area here, and then click it together, and then when you solder it, the white out will not will keep the solder from locking it up. Just a little hint there. But we're going to go over this at in another video. I'll actually show how to put the make the hinge itself. But today we're just going to focus on the hinge command itself. All right, let's get started. All right, in this video we're going to go over the hinge command. And there's a couple things. It can be on pretty much any shape that you have, but there's certain parameters that you'll have to make sure of, and that's that it's not totally closed. And what I mean by that is, you'll see in a second here. But the first thing, I drew out these curves, so we'll just select this one. Well, we'll get rid of one of them. I wonder if they, okay. All right. We'll select this curve, and then we'll go to our tools menu. Of course, right up here, go to profile, and it'll place it right there at the top, and we'll change it to the Z direction, and we'll also change the profile. I'm just going to use probably the same profile on most of these. There is one thing about the profile. If you're wanting to do a lot of maybe smart flow or something like that, it's probably better to go with something that has like a sharp edge. What I mean is, maybe do something like this one where well, it looks like they're sharp, but pointed, like this one here, right? And then you can round the top or whatever you want to do with that. But and you can round these well, I wouldn't round the edges if you're just going to do it across the top. But it'll make it easier in the long run. But let's just go ahead and select this one for right now. I'm gonna rush through this, so I apologize. And then we'll adjust it a little bit to make it a little easier to work with. I'm not gonna be very specific as far as the points and stuff. And then what I'm gonna do is, I'm just going to drag it over a little bit, and then I'll go ahead and check out mirror. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. Yeah, there it goes, it worked. Okay, so you can hinge a surface like this, which maybe if you want to start a new fashion as far as earrings, that might be pretty cool. And then we'll just go ahead and enter. And then what we'll do on this one is, we'll do a surface sweep one from here, here to here, and hit enter. And there's our surface. I'll go over making the earring part and the hinge in another video. I won't have time to do it tonight, I apologize. But there's our surface, and we'll just go ahead and accept that. And then we'll take our surface, and we want to go to cutters and go to our hinge command, and go ahead and click on hinge, and it'll put the hinge out there. I'm going to go to the front view. You can adjust the hinge depending on how wide you want it or whatever. But it won't show up if it's not, well, I'll show you. If I drag it way out here, it's not going to show. It needs to be in the area of where it encircles the curves or the surface. So you can play around with that. You can drag it to where you want it. You can adjust how wide you want the hinge to be. You can also adjust the inner circle, smaller, larger, you know, usually like around maybe, oh, that's way too big. Oh, no, it's all right. So that's how you can put the hinge on. It does it really, really quick, really easy. And then I'm just going to go ahead and accept that. And right now, everything is still grouped together. So what you'll need to do in order to put sprues on this and cast it, which I'll show in another video, some ways to be able to put sprues on this, is ungroup it. So just click on ungroup, and now everything is individually. So you can change colors, you can hide, you can do pretty much anything you want with it. Just hide that one, you know. So the hinge itself, the wire, you could probably delete, because your jeweler or the craftsman will put that in there himself. So we'll just go ahead and delete it. Well, it broke history. Let's bring it back. So we got our history back. So there you go. That's really the gist of it. You can, if you go up here, go to your edit. You can, if you want to do a render a certain way or whatever, you can render it closed. You can render it open. So you could set it up however you want. So I'm just going to leave it like that. And show you some of the others. There is one thing. If you're going to do earrings, instead of trying to flip it and everything, the profile is going to go wherever the seam point is. So it's always a good idea to check where your seam points are. And it's at the bottom. So if you're going to do a pendant, you probably want to go ahead and move it to the upper part. And I'll show you real quick. I'll go to Tools, go to my profile, and put it on a Z direction. Whoop, no, sorry. Put it on a Z direction. Z direction. Change the profile and to that same one. We'll just go ahead and keep using it. You can use any, of course. Adjust it a little bit. Bring it in, bring it down, and then again here you'll have to offset the curve a little bit. Okay, so I offset it to the Z. So let's take it back. Let's abort that command and put it on there again. Select curve. This time I'm not going to go to Z, and I'll. You saw why it was just sticking up to Z. We don't want that, so we're going to flip it. What is it? Probably a negative 90? We'll just do 90, see what it does. Yeah, okay, so there it's 90. And then we'll change it to the one we've been using. And we'll adjust it, bring it down, kind of do that. And then we'll drag it. Now it's going with the curve, which is what you want. And besides, you need that opening in order to get the earlobe in there, right? So it can go through. And like I said, in another video, we'll put a post on there and we'll make the actual hinge to show you how that's done. And then we'll just go ahead and mirror that profile. And it placed it over there. Well, that's not good. So let's just unmirror it, and we'll just put it out there ourselves. Front view. We'll go ahead and right around there. Okay, so did it place it in the right direction? No, of course not. And then we'll just flip it 90, see if that works. Yep, there we go. Okay, so now we're off, so we got the space for the earlobe to go in. We'll hit enter. We'll do a surface sweep one. Here, here, and here. Hit enter, and there we go. And we'll just accept that. We won't make any changes right now. And then to put the hinge on, go to your cutters, get your hinge, and there you go. And then again, you can probably better to do it the front view. Drag that up to where you want the point to be. How much of a cut do you want in it? And then just whenever you get it to inside diameter, you can change. There's a lot you can do with it. I'm just gonna show it real quick. I get finicky sometimes. And then hit enter. So there you go. You have an oval, you have a square that has rounded corners. You could do it with pretty much any shape. Here's a round. You could also do it with a ring rail. And we'll just do it one more time. Oh, this one's still grouped together. So if you ungroup it. Oh, complete command, sorry. Now it's ungrouped, and you can do whatever you want. You can manipulate the one side or however. You can save it and then just pull one out to get it ready for a sprue or something like that. And then we'll do one more with the circle. Let's see. We'll go to Tools, Profile Placer. Okay, see, this was at the bottom. Again, that's probably not the place you want it if you're going to do earrings. If you're going to do bangle bracelet, you'll probably want one on this side and one on this side to make the hinge on this side, or the hinge on this side and then the clasp on this side. And that'll be another video for another day. But right here, we're going to delete this because we need to move that seam point. So go here, go to Tools, Edit, go to my seam point, and we're going to drag it up there with my quad snaps on and snap it to the top. And now we're going to go back to Tools and put a profile on there, and we're going to flip it 90 degrees, and we'll do a different profile here. Okay, we'll do something like this here, and select it, and then we'll adjust it a little bit. And we'll adjust this down a little bit, and we'll go ahead and hit enter. No, we won't. We'll go to the front view, and we'll drag it over, and then we'll place another one over here. You could probably do a mirror on this one. Oh, I didn't place it up there anyway, so let's see. We'll flip that 90 degrees, hit enter. So there's our earlobe area, and we'll go ahead and accept that. And we'll go to surface one, sweep one, here, 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 hit enter, and there's our there's our surface. And then we'll go ahead and hit enter, and then again go back to cutters, go to hinge, and boom, there you go. And then you can adjust it how you see fit to do it on there. And again, it has to be let's go to the front view. Yeah, well, let's get rid of those. Let's take all of it. Oh, I can't. Get out. There we go. Okay. And then again, you can adjust the width of it if you want, or you could adjust the opening, and then just go ahead and hit enter, and it's grouped together. So we want to ungroup it, and then you can manipulate each side, sprue it up or whatever. But there you go. There is one thing: if you are doing a bangle bracelet, let's say, you know, sometimes you want more grid out there, so you can go to the command line and type in options and hit enter. And then from the command line, if you go to, where is it at, grid. Now right now it has well, let's move this out of the way. Right now, if you look here, it's 5, 10, 15, 20. So it has 20 on this side, 20 on this side, 20 on this side, 20 on this side. You can adjust that. You can actually go in there and say you want 40 because you're going to make something kind of big or something. So you can go in there and hit 40 and hit enter. And now you have 40. All right. You can also do a lot more in there. Options, go to grid. You can select each little small box, not the big box here, but the small box is 1 millimeter. The big box is 5 millimeter. You can adjust those as well. So there's a lot of things in here, and I'll actually get in here and sometime and show you. You can also adjust the units of each. You want, say, instead of millimeters, you want You want astronomical or units or light years. but there's a lot of adjustments you can do in there. And I'm just going to go back to my grid and switch it back 20 and hit enter. And now my grid's back to where it was as default.